Sifu Jason here. Thanks for watching. And let's get into a subject, and I don't mean to ruffle feathers just for the sake of it. I mean this with all sincerity, to try to help you from making, I think, a critical error. You know, like if I sell you a pair of shoes or whatever, and the shoes don't fit you too right, you know, you're going to have some mess up feet for a while. You know, you're going to have uncomfortable feet. You're going to be walking around, you're not going to be comfortable. If I sell you a mess up martial art doesn't work, I could kill you. So this is, in all sincerity, this is really serious business. There's a lot of bad Wing Chun out there. You may have noticed. Just go, put a link and find a video where Wing Chun actually does well against another martial arts style, or it really wins the street fight. You don't see very much of it, and that's a tragedy. So why? Well, there's a bunch of reasons. We're gonna go over a few of them. And first and foremost, too many people are training with the wrong tactical mindset, and that affects the way they're actually training in their school. They're training against Wing Chun fighters, so it's Wing Chun versus Wing Chun. And you'll see it every video. Watch the guy throwing the punches. Don't watch the Sifu Fantastic do his wonderful dance of death. Watch the guy throwing the shots. He's planting his feet, standing still, and throwing punches right down the center line with his elbows down, while the Wing Chun master does, you know, his Wing Chun stuff. If someone throws punches right down that center line, it's very easy for me to use a jump sao, or a pak sao, or a bong sao, or a gong sao, and catch the limb coming in. It's just a matter of, you know, physics. If it's coming down that line and I occupy that line, that's good. The problem with that is that the vast majority of fighters are not going to do that in a street fight. They're just not. They're throwing punches from different angles. And those punches are going to have power. You can sit there as a Wing Chun snob and say, well, this is a better, more superior, more scientific style of fighting. Listen, man, if you get hit in the chin hard, and you start blocking punches with your face, you're going to go bye-bye. I don't care what your Sifu told you. I don't care what certificate you have hanging in your wall. If you think that you can have your hands out in front of you and your chin up in the air and you don't have bridge control, you're not living in reality. You're not dealing with reality, okay? So bad training with only training against Wing Chun, Wing Chun versus Wing Chun, is the first most egregious error that you see in almost every Wing Chun system these days. So it's not meant for reality. Number two, they're doing Wing Chun, and though Wing Chun is supposed to be a system of concepts, no one's really using any concepts. They're doing it the same way it's been passed down. And let me point this out. In 1950, if there were Hong Kong street, you know, rooftop matches, Wing Chun versus other styles, what styles were they fighting? Chorley Foot? Praying Mantis? What were they fighting? Do you know what the odds are of me running into a Praying Mantis stylist in a street fight in the United States or Europe in 2017? What are the odds of that? I'm gonna run into people boxing, changing levels, going for takedowns and stuff like that, throwing round kicks, Muay Thai style. That's what I'm gonna probably run into. I'm not gonna run into anybody doing other Kung Fu styles with me. Furthermore, most of the people they were fighting, and I know this could be controversial, and I'm probably gonna take some flack for this, but this is just physics and I'm trying to help. I'm just trying to help. Most of the people they were fighting were under 150 pounds. If you watch boxing, there's not a lot of knockouts with fighters under welterweight. They don't have a lot of really hard punchers there because they don't have enough physics, they don't have enough body weight to just hit people and knock them out as much. It's just not as much body weight. Now think about this. If I take 5 pounds and I toss 5 pounds at you, and you know, okay. If I really whip the 5 pounds, that's more dangerous. I have to add a lot more acceleration to get that 5 pounds to be damaging. Well, if I have 100 pounds and I just hand it to you, it's a little bit more dangerous because it's 100 pounds. The point with that is that if you get a guy 200 pounds, 220 pounds, and they bow, and they throw a punch, and there's enough body weight to hit people and knock them out, they weren't really dealing with that. So they could fight in a style that maybe traded a shot here or there. You'd be real careful trading a shot to the chin with a guy who's 175 pounds plus. If you don't understand that, go to any boxing or MMA gym and just play around with them. You know, before you start giving me hate stuff and telling me I don't know what I'm talking about, you go, get in your car, go to a gym, and just try to swap shots with somebody who is over 175 pounds. I'm telling you, in boxing, they always say there's two types of boxing. There's boxing and there's heavyweight boxing. All heavyweight boxers have to have a great chin because every heavyweight can hit. And that's why there's weight classes. So they're fighting in a style that was working against 1950s type styles in Hong Kong that they no longer face. And they were against fighters that were 75 to, in some cases, 100 pounds lighter than the fighters are going to be facing in real life today. You know, it's not uncommon to be walking around and find a guy 220 pounds that's, you know, who's in pretty good shape, who can handle himself. That is a far cry different from fighting a 135-pounder, you know. Bruce Lee, Wong Sun-Leung, all those guys, all your heroes, they didn't fight guys that were 220 pounds and could move and fire. They just didn't. So I'm not saying Wing Chun doesn't work. What I'm saying is it has to be adapted. It has to be adjusted. Those concepts must be adjusted to work against the new reality. And those are the first big ones. Wing Chun versus Wing Chun, and then fighting with style and tactics that are no longer realistic. Those are the two big ones. We'll get to some others in the ensuing videos. Like I said, I can go on and on with the subject. And really, take a look at the videos out there and watch for those two big mistakes. Watch how MMA fighters, if they run into a shot, they're out. Okay? That's very dangerous to come in with your chin up and just get hit going in. And watch the videos of the Wing Chun people demonstrating, and you'll always see the same thing. Always Wing Chun versus Wing Chun. And you're never going to see that in real life. So that's a dangerous thing, to not differentiate between a training drill and an actual fight tactic. You know, it's like a boxer thinking that he can go out and hit a speed bag, and a speed bag is the way he wants to fight, and he goes out and tries to fight like he's hitting a speed bag. Obviously, every boxer in the world knows that that's just a training drill. Can you imagine the insanity of a boxer going out there and trying to hit like he's hitting a speed bag? That's what a lot of Wing Chun people look like when they don't understand the difference between a training drill and actual fighting. So what's my answer to that? My answer to this is that you've got to get Wing Chun the right way. What I mean by it is that we teach Ip Man Wing Chun, okay? We don't teach it the same way Ip Man taught it back in the 50s. That would be like trying to teach you Muhammad Ali style boxing. We're teaching you the concepts, the structures, and the fight tactics, and the training drills. So that's what we're teaching you. And so that is going to help you avoid having a Wing Chun that's just not usable. So when you're looking at it, and if it doesn't look like it's real, remember the point, watch the other guy being demoed on. If he's not doing anything remotely realistic, the stuff you're working on isn't going to work. That's why here we'll work a lot more on footwork, on proper bridging, you know, clinching, close quarter stuff, and so forth, to avoid those critical errors. It is Ip Man Wing Chun, but it's Ip Man Wing Chun applied to 2017 and almost 2018 now. So that'll help you avoid those horrible mistakes that get you knocked out or worse.